You know how to join two tables together in SQL, but how do you join three tables, or four tables, or 20 tables? In this video, you'll learn how to join three tables together, how your query changes when you add even more tables, and how you can adjust your joins to meet your needs. To join two tables in SQL, you use a join keyword. I'll show you how to do this in a tool called dbeaver, and I'm using a Postgres database, but the concept and keywords work the same in all SQL databases. Let's say we have a product table and a product category table. A product has a category. We want to see the product name and category name in the same result. To do this, we write a select query that uses a join keyword. There are a few types of joins, but for this example, we'll use an inner join. We specify the keyword inner join, then the second table to join to. We then specify the columns that match in each table. In this example, the category ID in the product table matches the category ID in the category table. We then need to specify which table that each column comes from. We do this by adding the table name before each column in the select clause. We can run this query and see our results here. We see product details and category details. What about joining three tables? Let's say we have a supplier table so we can record which companies supply each product. We want to show the supplier name along with the product and category details. How can we do this? The way we do this is to use another join keyword for this third table and then join to any other column that is already in a table in the query. It should be a column that contains the same data in both columns. In this example, the product supplier ID matches the supplier.supplier ID. So that's how we can write our query. The product table is already in our query, so we can join to that. Let's write the SQL for this. After the previous join condition, we add another inner join. Then we specify the table name, which is supplier. Then we specify the columns to join on. We can relate the product.supplier ID to the supplier.supplier ID. Now that we have joined this table, let's add some columns to the select clause. We'll add in the supplier name so we can see the name of the supplier for each product. That's all we need to do. Let's run this query. We can see our results here, which shows data from all three tables. If you want to get a quick reference to SQL joins and many other SQL features in different SQL databases, check out my free SQL cheat sheets. You can find them at the link in the description. You might have noticed the results are slightly different. Adding in this supplier table means that there are slightly fewer results shown. There were 24 rows shown before, and now there are 18 rows. Why is that? Well, it's because there are some products that don't have a supplier. We've used an inner join, which means the result is only shown if there are matches in each table. If a product has no supplier, we don't show the product because we have used an inner join. What if we want to show these products with no supplier? We can do that by changing the type of join we use. We change the inner join to a left join. Let's run this query. We can see the results here. We see another product that wasn't there before and it has a null value for the supplier name. Notice that we didn't change the other join type. You can use different types of joins for each table, different combinations of inner and left and right joins, depending on what you need in your results. What about four tables? You can repeat the same process. Add a join keyword, add the table name, and write the condition to match a column to a column already in the query. How many tables can you join in one query? There's no limit. As far as I know, there is no limit to the number of tables you can join in your SQL queries. A well-designed database will likely have many tables, and databases are efficient at finding the best way to run the query. We've learned how to join three or more tables in SQL. It's also possible to join a table to itself. Crazy, right? Check out this video here to learn why you would want to do this and how to do this in SQL. Thanks for watching.